This is the first time I'm using my tripod and my iPhone 7 in this lighting, in this setup. But anyways, Minnie is here. So let's acknowledge the queen before she gets too upset with us. Come here, boo-boo. Come here, Minnie. Come on, boo-boo. There she is. Hey, yo, everybody. I'm the hater queen. Because I hate everybody. Even my humans sometimes. Watch, poo-poo. Watch, poo-poo. She's camel shy. But she's very beautiful. And very majestic. Okay, Minnie, have some fun, okay? Don't be too mad. Oh, she wants to stay in my lap. Okay, so I went to Sprouts today. And I went to Trader Joe's. Cool. I literally only had one thing I needed to get from Sprouts. But then when I was there, I was like, Plus, it's been a while since I went to the grocery store. Like a week or something. I don't know. But anyways, the thing that I needed to get from there were brown rice, you know, crispy cereal. Because I'm going to make peanut butter rice crispies for my boyfriend's birthday party coming up. So yeah. And he likes them. And they're just from the brand Erewhon. This brand I talked about before, it's a really good brand. They actually have a store. I think they have a few stores. But it's like a long time legitimate health food brand. Okay, it's been around. Michio Kushi helped, you know, set it up. If you don't know who Michio Kushi is, look him up. He's the heaviest cat. One of the heaviest cats of all time. But anyways, yeah, it's sweetened with brown rice syrup, not sugar. Macrobiotics, people. It's another level. It's another level. But anyways, then I got these crackers, Back to Nature Organic. I got the rosemary olive oil because they're just good. And after I come home from work, which, or dancing, which work is dancing, it's like this, I'm like so tired and my roommates don't like it when I'm in the kitchen cooking and all that stuff late at night because, you know, they wake up early, so I have to just eat little snacks when I come home. Or if I had food already made, you know, just eat my leftovers. But sometimes they don't, so just eat snacks. So crackers and like hummus and whatever. But anyways, then I got the Sprouts Organic Apple Juice. I tried this a while ago, and it's actually really good. It looks like it's really nothing because it's just like Sprouts brand, and it's all plain and stuff. But this apple juice is pretty good. It's just fresh, pressed, unfiltered, pasteurized apple juice from fresh, tree-ripened organic apples. And I always like to use, like, you know, these kind of juices. I always like to put, like, 3/4 of the cup of the juice and then, like, 1/4 of sparkling mineral water just to dilute the sweetness, because otherwise it's, like, too sweet for me. And also, gives you a little carbonation. But anyways, then I got this Daiya Deluxe Cheddar Style Cheesy Mac. Because I've been craving like cheddar. Not just cheddar cheese, but like vegan cheddar cheese. So I just got this. And I like to put broccoli in my macaroni and cheese, because then it's like you get your vegetables and they don't taste nasty because it's mixed in with the macaroni and cheese, so it tastes good. But anyways, then I got this bath salt and soak pink Himalayan salt crystals with French lavender, because I've been thinking I need to get more Epsom salts. I mean, I don't use Epsom salts as much anymore, just because, you know, the way that I'm eating has helped reduce a lot of my chronic pain. And you know, other things that I'm doing too, acupuncture, chiropractor, chiropractic, you know, massage therapy is all, you know, it's all helping me feel better, so I don't feel the need to be soaking in Epsom salts every night like I was a few years ago. But I was just thinking because, you know, we're having our Nutcracker come up, and the last rehearsal really killed my feet, even though we didn't really do anything. It's honestly my pointe shoes are too small. There's a whole drama, the never-ending drama of my pointe shoes. It's just never ending. But anyways, isn't that a sign, Michelle? Maybe you shouldn't be doing pointe. I think about that all the time. But anyways, so I got these bath salts, French lavender, and also because stress is really getting to me, people. I'm getting really stressed out. I'm not gonna talk too much about it. But yeah, stress is really getting to me. And I don't like it that it's getting to me. So I need to, you know, be more aware of things that help me, you know, relieve my stress. So, lavender, Himalayan salt. Then this is a new thing that I got. Okay, at Sprouts, they have this little section where it's all these probiotic stuff, like you know, kimchi, different sauerkrauts, you know, and then in that same section they also have those coconut tarts that I always get. But they have a lot of different stuff, and I was like, this is too much stuff. I want to get it all, but I shouldn't get it all because that's too much money, girl, and you're probably not going to eat it all. So I just decided to get this Sinto Gourmet Gochujang Korean hot sauce. And this is tangy apple, naturally fermented in San Francisco, vegan, non-GMO, gluten-free. So I don't know, I just thought it was cool. Like, I don't know. It says gochujang is a hot chili sauce popular in Korea. We handcraft it the traditional way, using only quality ingredients, naturally ferment it with time and care. Enjoy it for marinating, stir-frying, dipping, topping, or to punch up stews or soups. So I was like, oh my God, cool. Just a little thing to give your food flavor. When all you eat is basically brown rice, vegetables, and beans, it definitely needs some flavor. Otherwise, I would not be motivated to eat it. Feel me? But anyways, then I got 2 cans of Eden Organic, no salt added beans. I got the navy beans and the butter beans. You guys know what I tried the other day? I really wanted to eat something with barbecue sauce, but like, the few days before, I was eating kind of fucked up, and I was like, if I eat something with barbecue sauce, it's most likely going to be a veggie burger or some other like kind of vegan junk food. And I really wanted to like eat really good because the days before I was eating kind of fucked up and I was feeling it. So like, what can I do? So I cooked the butter beans with a little bit of barbecue sauce, and I diluted it a little bit with some water, and it came out so good. The beans got so soft, and the barbecue sauce got all in there, and it was so good. So, pro tip. Anyways, then I got 2 of these. I used to buy these all the time, but I haven't bought them in a while. They're the Harvest Snaps. These two. Okay, this is like my all-time favorite flavor. The Caesar one is so freaking good. And then I saw this one today. It's actually lentil. It's not, you know, the snap pea crisp. It's a lentil bean, but this one's onion and thyme, or thyme, however you say it. But I was like, ooh, that sounds cool. And then they had this whole mountain of them, and then it said 2 for $3. And I was like, oh my God, that means I have to get two. So I got some, even though I didn't need to get 2. I was just like, oh my God, I have to get 2, a better deal. That's how they always get you. But anyway, then I got my Havoc corn chips. Honestly, this is not the best thing for my back right now because I've been feeling my left side where my back spasm happened almost a year ago. I've been feeling it like talk to me, and that's not a good sign, girl. But and this is like the worst thing you can eat for it. Baked, something so dry and baked, and like, it's like yongizing, contracting. Minnie, it's okay, boo boo. And what happens in a back spasm? So, you really shouldn't be eating this, girl. But I was craving corn chips last night, and so I was just like, we'll see. See, I know my I know what I eat. I know the consequences. But you see, biology is stronger than your what you know. You feel me? Even though I know that shit is not good for my back. I don't know. But anyways, then I got this Amy's roasted vegetable pizza with no cheese. This is actually so good. Okay. Trader Joe's used to sell one like this, but it was much cheaper. But this one is so much better. Honestly, the crust is amazing. It's just so good. This one is the queen. This one is the queen. So I'm not even mad at you, Trader Joe's, for not selling that pizza anymore, because this one's the queen. Sorry. Oops. But anyways, then, oh, in that same little section that I told you that had all that probiotic stuff, I got this Farmhouse Culture orange ginger carrots, and it's fermented vegetables. They had another one. I think it was beets or turnips, but it's a probiotic little fermented carrot thing. I was like, oh, another cool little thing, because probiotics help you in so many ways. I mean, it promotes your gut health, you feel me? And your gut health is so important to the rest of your body. You know, I mean, I can't explain it all right now, but it helps you poop, it helps your immune system, it just helps everything in your body, because your food, that's what you take in, right? And so that is the center, okay? That's how you live, is by eating and breathing. But how can you breathe if you don't eat? You're gonna die, girl. But anyways, I got this vegan egg. I never got this before, but I was telling my boyfriend, I just remembered this, when I was all psycho in my eating disorder, when I was in high school, I used to make this thing called, I called it a bean cake, okay? And basically, it's a whole thing, because when I was in my eating disorder, I basically tried every new trendy diet that there was, okay? That was part of my eating disorder. Everything, like everything now that I do is motivated by, you know, helping me be a, like, my motivation is to be the best dancer I can be, okay? That's my motivation for everything now. In my eating disorder, you know, all the years that I was in it, everything was motivated by, oh my God, is it gonna help me lose weight? Am I gonna get fat? Like, it was just all, that was all in my head. That was everything. Everything in my life, which, that's a very sad life to live. And I hope that you don't feel that way. And if you do, I hope you get help. But anyways, that's a very sad life. Anyways, so I was on this, one of the diets I was on that I was on for a long time, because it kind of seemed, this is the most fucked up thing, is like someone in an eating disorder, most of the time, if, you know, they're into like all the new trendy diets and all that stuff, and if you just look at them, you don't look too closely at what they're eating. You think they eat healthy, and everyone praises you for eating so healthy and da 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 da. But they don't know that you're really fucked up. And like, you know, I never ate salads with dressing. It was literally just the lettuce and maybe a few vegetables. Like, it was, you feel me? And people would praise you. That is so fucked up. That's like one of the many messed up things about our culture and our society, is like anything that looks like you're losing weight or like you're on a diet is like praiseworthy. And it's like, really, girl? I was in an eating disorder for like 11 years growing up, and everyone was praising me. Oh, everyone should eat like Michelle. I was like, cool, girl. Yeah, but you know, this is like the only thing I eat the whole day, and then I go home and I exercise for 5 hours and I hate myself and I cry every night. Yeah, cool. Yeah, you should really be like me. So stupid. But anyways, back to what I was saying. So I was on this diet called the South Beach Diet, okay? And it seems, and it's made, okay, it was a whole book, and I read it, and it was basically made for people who have heart problems. Okay, it's made for very overweight people who have health problems with their heart. That's what it was designed for. Okay, it wasn't designed for some 14-year-old girl, you know, who starves herself and doesn't need to lose weight anyways, you know. So anyways, so I was on that diet for a long time, and there was message boards, and I would go on the message boards, and everyone hated me on those message boards because I was so, you know, it had, you could have a tracker, and it said like starting weight, goal weight, current weight, you feel me? And like I just explained to you previously, that diet was meant for overweight, very obese people who had heart problems, okay, that were on that diet to help their heart problems, you feel me? And so here I am on the message boards, deep in my eating disorder, okay, and this was during a time where I didn't have any inhibitions when it came to talking about, I hate myself, I'm so fat, la la la, I'm so fat. I had no filter when it came to that. I just was talking because I thought, yeah, I am fat, everyone knows. It's fine if I talk about it. Like, I didn't really think about how other people would take my own self-talk, you feel me? So I would write on the message boards, I'm so fat, I wanna kill myself, all this stuff. And okay, back to the tracker thing. Okay, so my starting weight, because I didn't even really have a scale, so I never even really knew my weight, but I wrote my starting weight was 130, my current weight was like 115, and then my goal weight was like 75 pounds. Okay, you feel me? Okay, and so everyone would always get mad at me on those message boards saying, you have a real problem. They'd be like, you need to see a therapist. They'd be saying all this stuff to me. And I'm like, no, I'm so fat. It's a whole thing. But anyways, so they had recipes on the, they had like threads where it'd be like recipes and you can post, people can post recipes. And so someone posted a cornbread recipe, okay? And people, I love cornbread, okay? Always have loved cornbread. So I was like, ooh, let me try that cornbread recipe. So basically what it was beans. It was like light colored beans and some other stuff, you know, to make it like a cornbread thing. And then I loved it so much that I started doing different stuff to the bean recipe. So I started doing like cinnamon and sugar and taking out the salt, not sugar, Splenda. Girl, I eat copious amounts of Splenda, okay? Don't do that, okay? So I would make this bean cake like maybe like two or three times a week, and I would eat the whole thing at once, and my mom would be like, Michelle, I know that's, you know, supposed to be healthier. She's like, I don't think you should eat it all at once. And then I'd be like, stop calling me fat. Like, why is everyone always calling me fat? Myself. I was always like that, people. So if you were my friend during that time, if you knew me during that time, I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry. If you guys think I'm annoying now, I was so much worse when I was younger. But anyways, so I just told my boyfriend about that. I don't know what brought it up. I think we were talking about different cake recipes, you know, because my boyfriend, you know, eats, you know, macrobiotic like me. So we're talking about different things that we could do to make a cake. And I was like, oh, you know what? I used to make this bean cake. Blah, 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 blah. So basically, it's just canned beans with some sweetener, with some vanilla, and with some eggs. And you blend it, and it's a whole thing. So, P.S. And after I posted, after I started experimenting with that bean, that cornbread recipe, I posted it on the message boards. I made like sugar cookies, I made strawberry shortcake, coffee cake, all this stuff. Then everybody loved me on those message boards. Everyone was like, oh my god, yes, I love your recipe. Yes, but anyways, so I got the vegan egg to help make that bean cake. That's a whole story. But anyways, then, oh yeah, and then cannelli beans. It was mostly, I used cannelli beans and navy great white beans, just white beans. That was the thing. Anyways, if you guys want a cooking video of me doing that recipe again, the only thing, I mean, it was fine. The only fucked up thing about it in that recipe was the Splenda. But now I know, oh, maple syrup, brown rice syrup, barley malt, it's fine. But anyways, so let me know. That cake is good though. Okay, and then I got these Amy's organic chili beans, medium heat, and oh, one more thing. Oh, okay, at Sprouts, they have so many different kinds of hummus. They just basically have a whole wall of hummus. And I'm just like, what do I even get? There's too many to choose. So I just decided to get this balsamic caramelized onion hummus, and it's from the brand Cedars, and I'm excited to try it. Because like I told you guys, when I come home from, you know, teaching or from dance class, you know, I can't cook, okay? It's like disturbing to my roommates who are trying to sleep. So I always try to have snacks or, you know, so I could just eat and I don't have to be in the kitchen making all this noise. But anyways, that's everything I got from Sprouts today. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. I'll see you guys in the next one. And my face looks really red. Why does my face look red? You know what? I tried a sample of a moisturizer at Sprouts. It might be making my face red. Or maybe it's just the lighting. I don't know. Or maybe it's just hot today. I don't know. It is hot, but. See you guys in the next video. Later, haters. Think 10.